Hey, what's going on, guys? Anthony with Metal Miners. 4th of July, Independence Day here in the States. Hot in Florida, man. It is blistering hot. Took some time coming out of the sun and wanted to do a video, man. I've got a few records in from 20 bucks spin. I've had them here for a week or so. Actually, I've got one here that I'm not going to be showing. There's a little problem with it. I got to send it back. But four records and a tape I want to show you guys today. Be a quick video. I won't hold you guys too long. In the background, we're going to be listening to Ceremonial Oath. And the name of this one is The Book of Truth. Excellent stuff, man. Excellent stuff. Kind of stumbled on these guys when I was thumbing through what 20 bucks spin had to offer, man. They've been getting in some good stuff. This is a Floga reissue. Actually came out in 1993 on an outfit called Modern Primitive. They did a CD version of this. This cover art is by a guy named Al Benson. Death metal kind of seems to be a little confusion about what genre they fall in, especially on Metal Archives or whatever. You hear the vocals are kind of blackened. Man, I love this stuff. Swedish death metal is what I call it. Swedish death metal. The guys are out of Sweden. Four piece. You see the guys here. You get 11 tracks on this thing. You see they're all wrote in chapters except for the prologue. 45 and a half minutes of music. These guys were came with this like booklet for a inside there. It's got the lyrics and some band shots. Some more band shots and some cutouts there, collage on the back. These guys were active as Ceremonial Oath from 91 to 96, and then there was a big gap, and they came back in 2012. The Metal Archives shows them as active, but no new material since 2012. This was their debut full length, and following a demo and a the vinyl's over there on thing. Following a demo and a EP, this was it. No new material. This one gets mixed reviews. I mean, if you look on Metal Archives and read some of the reviews, people can't seem to agree on what they think about this. So you decide. Check it out. Listen to it playing in the background. Let me know what you think. Like I said, this is a Floga reissue. Great stuff, man. I really enjoy it. I really enjoy it. Think you will too. Check this out. Torture Rack. By the way, that one came on yellow vinyl. I don't know if you can see it back there, but yellow vinyl. Torture Rack, Primeval, Onslaught. Check out that art there by Rock, R-O-K, Rock. Death metal out of Portland, Oregon. This is their new release. You see there on 20 bucks spin. Look at some of those titles there, and you know what you get in that Northwest, Pacific Northwest death metal. Four piece, you see the guys there, 10 tracks on this one. A fast listen, 26 minutes and some change, something like that. Active since 2012, and this is their third full length. Nasty old school death metal with that Pacific Northwest flair. Of course, you got some members from Witch Vomit, Cemetery Lust on here. You know what you're getting into. Muddy production, shorter songs for the most part, straight to the point, the way I like it. Man, you can look at these guys and tell they're having a good time, not taking everything too serious. I love it, man. I've tried to pick up all their stuff. This one came on black vinyl. upside down no matter how I do it, isn't it? I can't help it, man. Man, I hope you guys are having a good day. I am. I've got my family here, got my grandchildren. I need to get out there where they're at, but I wanted to do this right quick. Mournful congregation. Slow it down a little bit. And this is the Exuviae of Gods, part two. You'll remember they put out the Exuviae of Gods, part one last year. Killer stuff. The cover art here is by Carmazid, I think is how you say it. I think the font's real small back here on the back. I think that's the way you say it. Australian Funeral Doom. You're familiar with these guys if you're into Funeral Doom at all. These guys are a five-piece. You can see the boys there on the back. Three tracks on this one, almost 40 minutes of music. These guys are legends, been at it since 1993. And like I say, this is the follow-up to last year's EP, the part one. This is the part two. I don't know if there'll be a part three or not. They're about due for a full length, but I was listening to Mark G with a C describe some Funeral Doom or a Death Doom band last week, and I can't really remember who it was, and he was using words like beautiful and stuff like that, and that's exactly what this is. You get some acoustic parts in here that are just beautiful music. It's slow, but it's not monotonous. Wonderfully written, masterfully performed and composed. I mean, these guys are legends. If you're not into Funeral Doom, if you're not into slower stuff, just call it something else and give this a listen, man. I'm telling you, you are likely to enjoy it. And it came, like I said, this is a 20 buck spin deal. Inner sleeve is black inside. 20 buck spin is doing an awesome job, man. Just an awesome job. Got a little problem with this one I can't get resolved, but as far as their output, and I'm sure they'll resolve it, don't get me wrong, but their stuff is just well done in every possible way. Here's the hype sticker right there. And this one came on translucent blue. Check out that music in the background, man. They mix genres up, don't they? I love it, man. I love it. Oh, one more record to show you. Check this out. Fetid. Woo! The demo finally on vinyl. Of course, it's out on Extremely Rotten. Check that out. Cover art by Ink Lesions. Seattle, Portland, I can't remember, Pacific Northwest Death Metal at any rate. A three-piece on this. You had four tracks, a little over 20 minutes of music. Just killer death metal. This was their first physical release, this demo was, and then they went on to have that full length in 2019 called Seeping Corporal Mess, and they're way overdue for something new. There's the three band members' name there, Clow, Julian, and Chelsea plays bass. Just killer stuff. As Mark G says, filthy, disgusting, horrible death metal. Raw, muddy production. Man, this is just excellent in my book. Come with this killer inner, some more of that killer art there. Like I said, I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but this one recorded in an underground base somewhere else by Fetid, January 2017 in Seattle, Washington. Just crazy good stuff. Insert art by Chelsea Love, I guess. Man, it's good. It is good. If you haven't heard Fetid and you're into that old school death metal sound that's so prominent in the Pacific Northwest, you need to give this a check. Give this a check, man. Give it a listen. Do your ears a favor. Your brain will thank you for it. Like I said, I don't think it's extremely rotten. Did this one, of course. I think I showed y'all that, but extremely rotten. Great stuff. Great stuff. Moving on. Last but not least, my newfound friend, Jason Skilz, sent Cody and I some BCLT, and I've got most of it over there for Cody to handle because it's black metal, ambient, drone, stuff like that. I've gave it a listen, but I think it's stuff that Cody would enjoy more, and I want him to do a video on it. He will. I think he's going to be up here sometime later in the week. But there was one cassette in there that I just snatched out of the pile, and that is War Master. I don't know if you can see it in there. Let me tilt it back a little bit where you can see it. The name of this one's Blood Dome. This was an EP that came out in 2013, and I think this version was actually the band did this one. There was another version that came out on an outfit called Torture Garden Picture Company, but I think this is the one that the band put out. Neil Dossie did this cover art. Let me show you again. Death metal out of Houston, Texas. Five piece on here. You get four tracks, 14 and a half minutes of music. Status is unknown there on Metal Archives, but they've been at it since 2009. Had a full length, a debut full length, their only full length in 2011. But old school death metal, no frills, meat and potatoes. Just the way I like it. I'm holding it upside down. I'm sorry. I know that guy's brains has got to be shook to the back of his head, but good stuff, man. I appreciate it, Mr. Skilz. You are a prince among us poppers. And there's actually a stack of stuff that he sent, and I'm going to let Cody delve into that because it is right up his alley, and I think he will enjoy it much more than I do. Although I'm sure that he will pull some of it out and say, hey, Dad, you need to check this out. And I will. I'll be glad to check it out. I actually listened to some of it enough to know that it's Cody's cup of tea. But Jason, man, I appreciate you. Cody will be doing a follow-up video on that. And we always appreciate anything that we get, man. We are we're happy to get it, man, but we sure appreciate it. Man, if you live in the States, I hope you're having a good 4th of July. Anywhere else in the world, I hope you're having a great day. I love the United States, man, but I love you guys in your country just as much, man. I hope everything's good with you guys. Hope you enjoy this video, enjoy what we're doing. Take the time, leave me a comment down below. If you don't like it, just tell me to go jump in the lake. If you like my hairdo, tell me I'm beautiful. Do what you want to do, but interact with us. We appreciate y'all. Thank you.